Well, for once, people are actually happy with my opinion. Nothing could possibly ruin my mood today.
You sure about that?
Ah! How the hell did you guys get in here so quietly?
Seriously, man, you're asking that now? Shouldn't you be used to this by now? It's time for your Sonic Advance 2 review.
Eh, fine. Wait, where's Tails?
He was arrested, remember? Yeah, what a dumbass he was for turning himself in.
Oh, right. Well, at least I'll have one less dickhead to deal with this time. So, Sonic Advance 2.
So if you've seen Mitchell's review of the first Sonic Advance, he said the game is enjoyable, but also said it's very flawed. And even though the bastard kidnapped me, I have to admit I do agree with him. The main problem with Sonic Advance was its lack of originality and the characters having pretty useless abilities.
So, here's to hope that the sequel eliminates the problems that the original had and is a vast improvement.
So unlike the first game, you need to unlock each character as you go by saving them from Dr. Eggman. The first zone is Leaf Forest Zone. Oh, for fuck's sake. You know what? To be fair to the gameplay style is a little bit different from the first game. Sonic Advance 2 has an emphasis on speed. The game is very fast-paced, so the fact that they use another grassy plains as the first zone maybe gets a pass. Eh, actually, you know what? Fuck that. I don't really think that's a good excuse to use another grassy plain setting. Just because it's more fast-paced doesn't give them the excuse to not make a creative starting zone. However, I do like the fast-paced style of gameplay. And hey, I guess I'll talk about each character as you unlock them. So of course you're forced to start as Sonic, whose abilities are just as useless as the first game. He still has the insta-shield, which is fine, but he also still has that dumbass somersault. Now, he can also do the homing attack in this game, but I never found it useful in a 2D Sonic game. Sonic also has a new ability where he can stomp down on the ground, but once again, I think it's useless. Now yes, I am well aware that all of the abilities I just mentioned can be used to take out enemies, but why the fuck would I use any of these abilities when I can just easily jump into the enemies? Now one more ability to mention before we move on is an ability that every character can do. It's a new ability where you can use a super hop after being launched in the air. You can do this to go up or to the left or right. This is one ability that is actually extremely useful and fun to use.
So good job, Sonic Advance 2. You finally made one ability that isn't completely useless. Congratulations.
Anyway, the first boss fight of the game is...
Actually, on second thought, let's leave the boss fights for later. I really can't deal with that right now.
So after you beat the first boss, you rescue a new character named Cream the Rabbit, who is looking for her mom, Vanilla. So you might be wondering what I think of Cream's gameplay. Well, she's actually my favorite character to play as. Aw, man. You see, Cream has a chow named Cheese who is always following her. You can use this chow to actually attack enemies for you. And yes, you can even use it on the bosses.
No, we're still not talking about that yet.
And if that wasn't overpowered enough, Cream can also fly just like Tails. Although I think that's pretty silly considering that rabbits clearly can't fly. Seriously, you're complaining that a rabbit can fly in a video game? You never complained about Tails being able to fly.
Yeah, obviously I didn't complain about Tails being able to fly.
What do you mean? Wait a minute, Arron, do you honestly think that foxes can fly in real life?
What? No, of course not. Why don't we get back to the review?
Hot crater, am I right? This is a fun zone. Now, technically, someone could argue that the molten rocky setting is similar to Lava Reef from Sonic 3 and Knuckles, but to me, it's different enough. Music Plant is next and is filled with a bunch of, well, the name should be self-explanatory. I love this zone. It's really creative and it's actually something original for once. So after you beat the boss of Music Plant, you rescue Tails. Now, Tails plays pretty much exactly how he did in the first game, so there's not much to say. Although I will say this, his tail attack is actually a little more useful in this game compared to the first game.
Although for some reason, you can't use his tail attack in the boss fights. Why? Well, because... No, not yet.
So the next zone is Ice Paradise, and...
Yeah, guys, you do realize that you already had a snowy setting in the first game, right? And not only that, it was also the fourth zone?
Yeah, talk about unoriginal. Now, don't get me wrong, I still enjoy this zone. It's got a bunch of rails to grind on as well as these fun slides, but my god, a rehash much? Next is Sky Canyon, and it's pretty good, I guess. Although it has a whole lot of these spinning things that shoot you in a different direction every single time, and it can get really irritating. You also fight and unlock Knuckles at the end, and yeah, he plays very similar to how he played in the first game, except that he can do a spiral dig towards the ground as an attack, and you can probably guess if I found it useful. Also, for some reason, his punch combo has went from 3 to 2, which is dumb.
But something else dumb is that you can't use his punch attack or gliding in the boss fights. Why? Well, because... Nope, not yet.
The next zone is Techno Base, and despite the fact that there's a shit ton of flickering colors everywhere, I do actually really like it. After that is Egg Utopia, and it has a gimmick involving switching the gravity. And it takes place in space.
Ugh, do I even have to say it? Guys, you do realize that not only have you used this gimmick in the final zone of the last game, but this isn't even the second time you've used it in a Sonic game. Get some fresh ideas, you fuckheads!
Man, calm down, there's no need to be rude.
Shut the fuck up, Knuckles.
Ugh, god, I guess there's no avoiding it now. But before I get into the boss fights, I need you to know that I don't think this game is bad. In fact, there is aspects that did improve upon the first game. Each of the characters have been improved upon when it comes to their abilities. Not every ability works well, but there is that. Also, I think despite the unoriginality of the zones, the majority of them are better than the zones in the first game. I also like the fast pace of the gameplay, and I also really like the music. Now, if we're just talking about those specific aspects, I would maybe say that it's better than the first game, and I would probably give it a 7 out of 10. However, if you were to include other aspects of the game, such as the boss fights, it goes from a 7 to a fucking 5 out of 10.
Okay, I can do this.
With every single boss in each of the zones, you have to run after Eggman in one of his contraptions. Why is this a problem? One word, momentum. You need to build up speed in order to get to Eggman. Once you jump up to hit Eggman, your character is almost always thrown back to the end, and you then have to build up momentum again. Now you might be thinking, oh, this must be when the abilities come in handy, right? Well, tough shit. If you attempt to use Sonic Somersault, for example, the game straight up just doesn't allow you to, and you immediately lose all momentum and are sent back to the end. This also goes for Tails' tail attack and Knuckles' punch combo. Oh, and if you think that trying to fly as Cream or Tails or glide as Knuckles will make it easier, that also won't work. And don't give me that bullshit, well, Arron, it's realistic physics. Of course you would lose all momentum by trying to fly to Eggman. I don't want to hear any of that. This is a game where a rabbit can fly by flapping its fucking ears. It shouldn't be realistic. Because of the momentum problems, it makes every single boss fight complete bullshit. And even without the momentum problems, Sky Canyon and Techno Base's bosses are just really difficult.
Now here's the thing. If it were just the boss fights being annoying, I probably wouldn't be making such a big deal out of this. But the boss fights are part of a larger issue with Sonic Advance 2.
You may have noticed that I still haven't talked about the final zone. The final zone is called XX and...
Heh, imagine if there was one more X.
Not now, Knuckles. I'm not in the mood for your shitty jokes.
Anyway, this zone is terrible. So do you remember just now when I was complaining about how terrible the boss fights were in this game? Well, what if I told you that you need to beat all of those bosses over again in a boss rush before you get to the actual final boss? That's right, you need to beat 7 of the previous terrible fucking bosses, one after another. Now, they don't take as many hits this time around, but still, how fucking frustrating is that? Now, you may remember in the first game, you also had a bit of a boss rush in the final zone. But the thing with that is you only had to fight 2 of the bosses from the Genesis games as a fun joke. It was the ball and chain boss from Sonic 1 and the drill boss from Sonic 2. It was just something funny that they put in as a bit of a joke. But Sonic Advance 2 has you fighting every single boss over again before getting to the final boss. This final zone pissed me off so much the first time I played it as Sonic that I didn't even finish it. Please, if you play this final zone, at least use Cream instead of Sonic, because you can quite literally cheese the fight by using cheese.
But wait, it's not over yet. I think you know where I'm going with this.
There's an extra boss with Super Sonic that can only be accessed by getting all of the Chaos Emeralds. How do you get the Chaos Emeralds in this game, you ask? In each act, there's 7 special rings hidden throughout each. You need to collect all 7 of these rings in a certain amount of time in order to even get to the special stage. In order to complete the special stage, you need to collect a certain amount of rings before the timer runs out.
And that's how you get just 1 Chaos Emerald. You need to repeat that process 7 fucking times, just for a supersonic final boss in space that we've seen a million times before. And you also might be wondering, why didn't I talk about Amy Rose? You may notice that she's not on the cover of the game. That's because they decide to make her a secret unlockable. How do you unlock her? I'm so glad you asked! You need to beat the game and collect the Chaos Emeralds with each character. That means you have to go through the process of finding 7 hidden rings in each act and collect a certain amount of rings in the special stage. In case you didn't know what 7 times 4 is, it's 28. You need to go through the process of collecting 28 Chaos Emeralds to unlock Amy Rose. Oh, but don't forget, you also need to suffer through the boss fights 28 times, which also means you need to do the boss rush at the end too, which means you actually need to fight the bosses a total of 56 times! All of this just to unlock Amy fucking Rose, a character who I don't even like playing as.
Alright folks, sorry about that, I'll explain the situation. Basically, we had to take Arron to a mental asylum as a result of having to review Sonic Advance 2. Although if you ask me, I think this has been building for a while. I mean, this is his 35th game review, so maybe that's the reason he went insane. But wait, if Aaron's in a mental asylum, who's gonna review the next game? Ah shit, that's right. He's scheduled to review the next Mario Kart game. What are we supposed to do? Hey guys, I'm back from jail! Huh? Where is everyone?